this is gonna be a very interesting video. Now, I haven't talked about this at all, and I've done that with purpose, but it's no secret that I wanna have both generations of the Supra, the Mark IV and the Mark V, the two ultimate generations of the Supra. If you guys can recall, about a year ago, I went to a secret meeting that I said I was not allowed to say anything about. I was very, very excited about it. I signed an NDA, they took my phone, they took away all the stuff, and they said I couldn't speak about it at all for like 6 months or so. Well, that meeting that I went to was for a Toyota Supra. Before it was even announced, I got the opportunity to sit in the new Supra, look at it up close, play around with it. Wasn't allowed to drive it, but I was allowed to see everything. The purpose was to get opinions from car enthusiasts that they chose, receive feedback from us to what we thought about it, to the options that they made it, to the price point, all of that stuff. Now, when I was there, I did everything in my power to say, get me on a wait list. I'm ready to buy this car the moment it comes out. Now, I got some groundwork with that, but nothing's for sure and nothing's promised. And I'm not gonna talk about any future plans with this car, but what I will say, and I think it comes as no surprise to you guys, I want that damn car and I want it bad. So with all that being said today, it kind of dawned on me. I wonder if I can go to every Toyota dealership in my area and simply talk to the GM, tell them I want to get the car and see what I'm able to do or what anybody can do to try and get one. I'm gonna have to be smart here. I'm gonna have to use my tactics. I'm gonna explain to them who I are and I'm gonna tell them my plans and what I want to do. And who knows? I might get every single door shut in my face or I might get lucky. I've been tipped off that things like this have worked in the past with other people that I know. So we're gonna give it a shot. We're gonna find out today, is it possible to secure a Toyota Supra before it comes out? Let's figure it out together, boys. As you guys know, dealerships don't respond unless you pull up in something that they think you're ready to play in. So today, we have to look serious. We have to look like an adult. The only option is to take the 458. So first things first, let's talk about what we do know. We do know that the 2020 Supra will be released before SEMA. SEMA is where every car brand wants to show off their newest thing, show off the best. So we know it's gonna come out before then. Even when I went to that meeting a year ago, they didn't even know when it would be coming out. They just knew that it would be sometime at the end of 2019. The most recent car that has come out that it kind of has the same hype as the Supra is the Civic Type R. Now with that, to my understanding, Honda gave every dealership, at least in California, at least one Type R for the first couple months of it being released. And of course, MSRP was jacked up like crazy. I think when they first came out, they were asking $20,000 over sticker. So with that knowledge, it's a pretty safe assumption to say that Toyota is probably gonna be giving most of their dealerships at least one Supra at the beginning. Then once that one Supra gets sold from that dealership, they're probably gonna wait a little bit to get more Supras out because they're trying to build that hype up. So I guess the main objective for today is to try to go to one of these locations and do everything in our power to be that first car that they sell. The odds are they probably have a client or a customer in the pipeline already, or they have some dedicated customer that's been buying all their cars here for the last 10 years and they put in the word a while ago. We're a little bit late to the game, but I thought trying is better than not trying. I might look like a fool doing this, but it also might, just might, secure us an early access to a Supra. Today's video is sponsored by Raycon earphones. Raycon earphones start about half of the price of other premium earphones on the market, so that's a great starting point for these. A cool fact about the company is that Ray J is actually a co-founder of these. These earphones come in a bunch of different colors and sizes, and they even come with a sizing chart. These are great because it allows you to custom fit these to your ear to make sure that they stay in and don't fall out. Like if you're at the gym or even you're working on a car and you're hanging upside down and hanging over, the size chart allows you to get that perfect fit so the headphones stay in at all times. These earphones have about 5 hours of playtime, and it even comes with a charging case too that takes only an hour to recharge them. A great feature about these Raycon E50s is that you can answer phone calls from the actual earphones themselves, which is a great feature because I always hate headphones that don't allow that because it's always a pain in the butt. The E50s have great sound quality and have a great price point. So right now, if you go to raycon.com/CJHunt, you can receive up to 20% off of your order. Click the link down below to learn more. Thank you so much, Raycon, for sponsoring today's video. And now let's get back to it. Pulling up to our first stop of the day. Thank God for the lift kit because I literally would be taking off my front bumper right now. I'm nervous because I'm preparing myself to get shut down, but you won't know if you don't try, right? I'm gonna go inside, I'll film when I can, but if there's anything that I've learned over the last 5 years of filming in public with a camera in a place that isn't yours, is don't film in a place that you don't own without asking for permission. So I'm gonna put the camera kind of low key. If I can film, I will, and if not, I'll update you guys in 5 minutes.
A few moments later.
Okay, so that was pretty interesting. One, shout out to those two guys that were here too, that came and said what's up. It wasn't a no, they were actually very interested. I pretty much said, hey, this is who I am. I make videos on the internet, this is what we do. I'd like to work with you guys. And off the bat, they said, Pete, there are people who are like trying to get the car, which we obviously knew. But they said people are gonna be offering, there's like an infinite amount over sticker. People are like, well, people just keep trying to one up each other. But he said, they gave me their info, they want me to send them some videos, and they said, give them a call tomorrow or Friday, and they're gonna talk to someone higher than who what they were to see if maybe it's possible. And they said they're expecting one to get in late July. Oh my god, that's this month. I didn't even know that. Wow. Okay, that's pretty good news. Okay, location one, kind of a success. It's what I hoped. It's what I hoped for. So that's good. We're on to the next one. All right, we're pulling up to the second location of the day. To be honest, bringing the Ferrari really does help, because when you pull up, it already puts a lot of eyes on you, as kind of screwed up as that is, but it like makes them take you just a little bit more serious. This is a larger dealership, so I think that should help us out a little bit. All right, same goes as last time. If I can film, I will. Attempt number two. Here we go, wish me luck. So this dealership has one coming in like very, very soon, and they are actually printing out the spec sheet on it. Doesn't seem like anyone's tried to buy it yet, I'm not quite sure, but they're gonna be pulling in the GSM to talk to me in a second, but I don't know, this one seems a little more attainable. I'm gonna try to feel it out a little bit when he comes back. We'll see what he says. I'm very nervous, by the way. My hands are like shaking. I have no idea why. It could be the monster. Too much caffeine.
Yeah, there you go.
Hey, all right, man. Shout out to you.
No worries,
I just
bro.
Got that thumbnail. You're gonna help me, right?
I got you, bro.
You're gonna try and help me.
It's yours.
Okay, all I right, hope man. So. Hey, take it easy, dude. We had some more success. On this time, they actually gave me paperwork that what exact spec they're gonna get. I'm not gonna say anything, because I don't want any of you motherfuckers to try and buy this car before me. Not a loss, definitely a success in my book. But they have, I'm not even gonna describe it to you because I don't wanna give any information away, but they have this one coming in. Again, they told me very, very soon. They're gonna give me a call, and I made an offer on it. I outbid the guy who already put an offer on it by a lot to try and get this car. So looks like that's the name of the game. Second dealership done. Again, running into like you guys everywhere. Apparently a lot of you guys work at Toyota dealerships. There's subscribers literally everywhere, which helps my case. So I'm like, hey, like I do social media, like this is who I am. And every time as I'm explaining that, there's like two or three of you that go, oh my God, TJ. I'm like, helping the cause, brother. You guys are helping more than you know. All right, this one down, on to the next one. The one thing that both dealerships have said so far is that the GM of the dealership, which both times I haven't been able to get in touch with, which I didn't expect to, but that's who I'm trying to talk to. They both said that he is the one who decides how much it goes over sticker. Every dealership knows that the car might go for 20, 30, 40 over sticker. But right now, they're like, if you made an offer on the car and if it was, you know, if it hit that sweet spot that the GM was looking for over sticker, they would like mark it as sold right now. So they're gonna let them know what I said. I doubt it's gonna be enough. I feel like dealers are gonna be looking for like 30,000 over sticker, which is a lot over sticker, especially because in 3 months time, they'll be way cheaper. But it's pretty much, it sounds like it's in the GM's hands. If it hits that magic number that he's looking for, he'll mark it as sold right on the spot. We're about 10 minutes out from the third dealership. Fingers crossed, we at least get the same thing or maybe something a little bit better. All right, boys. We at our third stop. I'm finding that the bigger the dealership, the more information they have. This is by far the largest dealership that we've been to so far. So real fingers crossed that we get some good news here. Probably the largest Toyota dealership I think I've ever seen. This thing is massive. We're pretty far from home right now, but it's all worth it in the long run, boys. All right, same goes as usual. Let's see what we can make happen. All right, that one did not go as well as the other two. Apparently, their Supra that they have coming in is already sold. It's been locked down. And then the second one they have coming in probably won't be a launch edition, which I'm very much after a launch edition. But it's very interesting. When I was in there talking with them,
it took him a second to understand that. Well, I told him that I make videos on the internet, whatever, and it took him a second to understand that I wanted to buy one. They thought I was trying to borrow one from someone. I was like, no, like, I'm willing to buy, and I know that I'm willing to pay it over sticker price. And it kind of, like, everyone on the floor, like, kind of holds. I stop and listen to the conversation. It's just, it's always funny. It's just the blunt reality of it, and that's totally fine. But on this one, no one saw me come up in a Ferrari. So I think because of my age, and no disrespect, like, I totally get it. That's just reality. That's just the way it is. They, like, didn't think I was, like, serious about buying one. So it took a minute to, like, be like, no, like, listen, I know the story, I know all that. Let's cut to the chase. What is it gonna take for me to get one? So this one looks like it was a bust, but like I said, not everyone's gonna be a win. And you can't succeed if you don't fail. Or I guess you technically could if you just, like, get it off the bat. That's regardless. On to the next one.
It's 93 degrees out right now. I'm, like, deep right now in, like, East County, San Diego, where it's, like, piping hot and there's, like, 0% of humidity. Oh my God. If you don't remember, I don't have AC in this car because I keep forgetting to recharge the AC. I'm gonna go into the next dealership dripping sweat. Even with the windows down, because this car is just such a hot car in general, oh my God. I'm literally sweating. I'm sweating from my face right now. We're like 15 minutes out. I cannot wait to get to the next dealership and just sit inside and get a cold water. All right, here we go at the fourth stop. Your boy is officially soaking in his own sweat. I'm bathing in it at this point. I just hope the smell of myself doesn't scare anybody away. Hopefully they have some info. Fingers are crossed, boys, fingers are crossed.
We're parked up, ready to go. We're super sweaty. Let's get it.
Few inches later.
So unfortunately, the GM wasn't there, but he's gonna be in tomorrow morning. Seeing a pattern here, the GM never being here. But they have one that hasn't been sold yet, and it's actually in the United States, and they said they're expecting delivery. I'm not gonna tell you when, but very, very soon. They, like, had an expected delivery date. So I don't know. I'm seeing a common theme. Every dealer kind of says something different, you know, of like, oh, well, this dealership already sold theirs 40 over sticker, and this one sold theirs 50 over sticker, and seems to me like the GMs kind of, like, play what off of other dealerships are doing. That being said, this was a win in my book. We're ahead of the curve on this dealership. Off to the last one, which allegedly they already sold theirs, but we're gonna fact check that and see what happens. I mean, no, I'm definitely interested. If I can, I just wanna see, I'm waiting to hear back from, like, one or two other dealers if they can get a launch edition or whatnot. But I mean, like, I definitely appreciate it. I'm definitely interested. Like I said, I'm just trying to get one. If it's possible for you. Oh my God, I'm sweating. So that was one of the dealers that I was currently at. That dealer said that they already sold their first one, but he's like, yo, I'm calling the port right now to try and see if I can get you another one. It wouldn't be launch edition, but he's trying to sell it to me, which I appreciate that. And I told him, my wish list is obviously a launch edition. I think that's everyone's wish list. Sorry. That's my wish list, but if I was like, if you can give me an actual date, he told me it wouldn't be until, like, September, and I was like, that's a little long. If you can make it quicker, as in, like, within weeks, like, that'll be a lot more tempting. So I don't know, we're definitely headed in the right direction. I like that. We're almost at the next dealership.
Coming up on the last one of the day. Fingers crossed we get some different luck this time. Who knows, we might get lucky. This is a huge dealership, so I'm feeling lucky about this one.
Okay, here we go. Sweaty Tej, going for the kill.
12 seconds later.
All right, it's no surprise that the largest dealership out of all of them, for sure, they said already sold theirs. And they're like, oh, well, we have a list that you can put your name on, and there's 7 people in front of you. And I was like, nah, fam, I ain't interested. Thank you for your time. We have 2 very solid leads. One that's, like, might be promising, so that's good. I'm completely out of gas and I'm dripping in sweat. I have 32 miles till empty. So let's get home and get in some AC, and let's go over all of our options for today.
Okay, that was a pretty successful day. I want to start off by saying that I didn't want this to be a video. I was doing my best to keep this a surprise for as long as possible. I wanted to just come out of nowhere and reveal it to you. But I thought it would be pretty cool to kind of share this process and show the process, how one would get one. I also want to note that the full send that I've been talking about is not the Supra. This is not the full send that I've been telling you to keep your eyes out for. This will be a sweet addition, but is not the full send. But let's go over what we know. Two out of the five dealerships that were there actually had the spec list on the launch editions that they were getting. So these are the ones that I placed an offer on. One of them, I placed an offer on this one, and I don't really want to show you guys the specs on it. And then this one, I'm going in actually tomorrow morning for a follow-up meeting to make a bid on it. I'm not too sure what to expect here. I'm trying to do everything I can to leverage myself to be a candidate for the dealership to choose. Maybe if we're lucky and if the dealership is cool enough, if we end up securing one, we can do a local grand reveal at the dealership and I can tell you guys, and we can do like a big meet and greet outside of the dealership and do like a pull in the sheet interview. That'd be pretty cool. But I'm gonna keep you guys updated on what happens. I don't know if we're actually gonna get one. Like I said, there's so many people lined up for every single one. I'm doing the best I can. I really don't wanna pay a ridiculous amount over sticker. I think realistically, spending anywhere from 20 to 25, maybe even 30 is where almost every car is gonna be selling at. And they have it listed at 57,896, and that's the launch edition, fully spec'd out. And keep in mind, there are different models of the Supra. There's like a four banger, and then an inline six, and then an inline six turbo. This is obviously the inline six turbo, which is the highest rated package, fastest one out of all of them, and it's the one that you've seen on like all of like everyone's like PR days where they get to go drive the car or whatever. So fingers crossed, if anybody out there